not just aces. Judging by the scratching behind the walls, better get the fuck out.
Give me a sec, guys. Okay. Where's my audio on here? Okay, master volume needs to be like 1. Okay. So I'm gonna explain this to you guys. We're gonna be this is gonna be how to do everything in Black Ops 4 Blood of the Dead. So this will include to get the Hell's Retriever, the shield, and how to get pack a punch. So without further ado, let's get started. So you spawn down here. Of course, we have the 4 containers that Misty and the transit characters were at, as well. You just need to go up to this door and get enough points. I'm doing this in custom mutations because I don't want to do it in there. So after you get enough money, you might want to come down here and just buy this door. I don't suggest buying like everything, of course, but yeah. So you can go through this way, or you can just run straight over and buy that door. But essentially, you just want to walk straight in here and turn on the power. You will open your first perk. Now, I forgot to mention, I will show you how to get all the buildables that we can build. So this includes SHAREfactory. I totally forgot to mention that. So this will be the suitcase we need. I'm going to go ahead and buy this. But it will always spawn in that location unless you turn it off completely. So, and we have a dog head here with a chest box. So you just want to fill this dog, essentially. So, I'll see you guys when I fill the dog. Okay, guys, last zombie. The dogs take 6 zombies in total to feed. As you can see, that was my 6th zombie. You can't actually see that it's my zombie, but it disappears, right? So there's always like 2 exits everywhere. You're like, how do I get out of here, right? This way? No. Now, if you're like just trying to learn everything, I suggest go on custom mutations. But essentially, if you buy this door, you've already seen the catwalk. For people who don't know how to open it, you just have to essentially go down this tunnel over here, go through that door, and buy power. Well, don't buy it, but open it. After that, you unlock this. I should just have the katana sword. This is where you rack up a lot of points. Like I said, I'm on custom mutation, so they can't really knock me because I've turned it down substantially. So when you get here, you want to have a good gun and you just want to open fire on the warden. Hit him as many times as you can and you just want to continue to run. So if you did this correctly, you know, the warden will be walking and you can feel your controller vibrate. Which means you've done this the easiest way you can. Now, if he doesn't spawn, of course, it is a glitch, and I do apologize. Sometimes you'll feel his vibration, I'll just say that. So, is that him? That is him, my bad. He'll spawn. So after you kill the warden for the first time, he'll drop a key. You want to pick up that key because that is the first part of our shield, as you can see. So after you do this, you just want to run through here. And you can buy this if you want. It just leads that way. I go this way for a reason. There's these panels on the wall. Like this one. This could have some blue alien goo on it. If you buy this, if you go, well, I'm gonna go buy this real quick. But if you essentially just run across here and go down here, blue alien goo could be right here. The last final location that this could spawn for you guys is all the way right here. Now you wanna go pick this up, and you have your second part of your shield. So now you're wondering, what do? You can go buy everything if you want, but usually what I do is I go fill up the dog. So let's go fill up the dog. Just wait for a few zombies to come by and we'll poke them, stick them, and stab them. It's one dog. Two zombies now. Or we just need two more zombies and we'll be fine. We're good on zombies. Dude, we got that on borderline right there. So many zombies right here. That's five. That's six. Okay. So after you fill up the dog, you're like, okay, let's go to the warden's office. You cannot, as you can see. It will not let you. You want to head towards the dock, essentially. So, if you know how to get to the dock, well done, then that way. So, well, you can see that we've done both of dogs. We have one more. And the reason why you need to go to the dock is because the last dog is on the other side of the warden's office. So let's head down here. I can't remember which one it is. Is it this one? How about this is the next one? Correct? Okay. So one of the spawn locations for the next shield part, which is the last shield part, could spawn right here. It'd be a cell door. If not, whatever. Also, if you have the warden's key, you can open this. Now, don't worry if you can't open the warden because you didn't kill him. This is where you can get him. So, second location could be right here. The last location will be somewhere right there. So, if you're like, what do we have to do to get that working? Just have to walk in here. Now, you're not going to have to go to afterlife and shock these things like you had to. See? The place is already open. All you gotta do is walk through here and look for one of the power switches. Turn it on. The warden will spawn. This is where you can get a free warden. If you did not get the warden. See though, he will not drop the key. Also, all the lights came on when that happened. So, now, open this door and you can build your shield. I built the spectral shield. Now, I don't know what you guys use, but I use it normal. You can see this. So, everything is still here. There's a lot of things you can and can't do here. So, as you can see, the dog's not on the wall. Essentially, you just want to go back to the top now. Forget everything that's down here. Forget that I opened that. That's not important unless you're trying to do the Easter egg, which I will not be showing you because I have failed on every Easter egg except for the Origins Easter egg. So, and the Mob of the Dead Easter egg. I almost did that one. I just died. But I've done it before. Anyway, you just want to head to where you can access the warden's office. Now, you do not want to take that just yet, and essentially the one that leads from warden's office to there and there will the warden's office from the beginning of the map where I showed you that it would not let us because we had to turn on the power, but it will take you to that one. So see, you can see it's open now. If you have the warden's key, that's a SHAREfactory. We have the entire shield and two SHAREfactory points. You got your perk location as always. And now you have opened the area. There's the dogs and here's the warden's house. You can just walk in this house, yada yada yada. So just wait for zombies. There's one. We need six. So I'll see you guys when I get all the zombies killed. I've successfully, killed the dog. So let's go get our retriever part. Now let's go get Hell's retriever, redeemer, whatever. No, it's not upgraded. My bad. All you gotta do is head to the warden's house, and we're gonna go to the showers. So if you're going down this way, you have to go up the volcano. Watch really closely on your screen for words. If you hold it just in time, you'll be able to pick it up. It'll say it real quick, but yeah. So now we have this. Yeah. So we can use this essentially to get the free blondergat, but that's not for this video. So this, we're gonna go get our SHAREfactory parts. So you need to head to infirmary. Don't know where that at. Go back to the start. You walk straight from the door I opened. From the start, you walk straight up. Now there's one location this has to spawn, so I suggest you have the warden's key if you will need it. There's the lock. Go up to it and open it. You can just walk up here. You have your SHAREfactory punch, right? You're like, how do we get pack punch? How do we go to the bridge and everything? You do not go to the bridge. No one accepts. Pack punch songs right here. Now, you have to have the shield for this part. But if instead of doing this, if you push right trigger on any controller, you will collect a soul. You need to collect 3 zombie souls in order for this to work. You'll hold this and it'll say Spirit Blast, R2, RT, or right mouse button. But just suck the souls from 3 zombies and you'll be fine. Now, essentially when I hold it, I've already done it. So just Spirit Blast that and you'll get this little animation. Still spawn in, pack a punch. Do I have to kill you again? This is like the 3rd time I've had to kill you. So this was the tutorial of how to get Pack-a-Punch, the SHAREfactory kit. Now, before we end this, I'm gonna go show you where to build the SHAREfactory kit, because obviously a lot of people don't know where they can build it, considering that they've not either played Mob of the Dead or they just forgot and think something's somewhere else, because this is a boomer. All you have to do is walk up these stairs, go to the Michigan, and all you gotta do is walk up like you're going to the gondola. Just walk straight over to the left and you can build the SHAREfactory kit. There you go. There's your blondergat SHAREfactory. Why does he spawn all the time? Come on, man. Come on. Can't remember, it's me. Oh my god, we killed him. Okay. So, hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Please smash that like button and subscribe if you feel like it, if you enjoy what I do on my channel. As well as turn on post notifications so you never miss when I'm live streaming on Ark, this, or even Hello Neighbor. So, guess this is bye now, and I will see you.